Hello everyone, this is Athriya and welcome to our channel Code Chef. Today we're going to be solving the problem Chef swaps digit, the difficulty level of cakewalk. Let's get started. Here it's written that Chef has two positive integers A and B. He can tamper with them by choosing a digit in the decimal representation of A and a digit in the decimal representation of B, and we swap these digits. These operations can be performed at most once. Find the maximum possible sum of the resulting numbers which Chef can obtain. So basically we have two numbers A and B. He can tamper with them by choosing one digit in the decimal representation of A, one digit in the decimal representation of B, and swapping these digits. This operation may be performed at most once. Find the maximum possible sum. So let's look at a few sample cases. We have here the 13 and 82 as our inputs. Now we need to find out what is a maximum. First of all, A plus B normally without swapping at all, we get the output as 95. Sum is not output, sum as 95. Now can we swap something to get a bigger basically output? For every number, because in this particular problem, it is very important to note that both A and B are less than or equal to 99, which basically means that they are guaranteed to be at most two digit numbers. Okay, so here in the worst case we have four computations that we can do. If we know this is A1, this is A2, this is B1, this is B2, we can swap A1 with B1, we can swap A2 with B2, we can swap A1 with B2, and we can swap A2 with B1. Only these, right? A1 B1, A2 B2, A1, B2 and A2, B1. These are the four swaps that are possible. In each of these swaps, we can find out the maximum. For example, here in the next slide, I have written all the four possible swaps here. Basically, if we swap A1, B1, if we swap B1, B2, if we swap A2, B1 and A1, B2. Now, these are the four conditions. For example, if I swap A1 and B1, now this 8, which is part of B1, comes here. So, 83. Then this 1 goes here, so I get 12. If I swap B1 and B2, if I swap A2 with B2, this 3 here goes here. Now this becomes 83. And this basically comes here, this becomes 12. If I swap A1 and B2, what happens? If I swap A1 and B2, this is A1, this is B2. So 2 comes here, it becomes 23. And 1 goes there, it becomes 81. If I swap A2 and B1, what happens? This 3 goes here and this number becomes 32 and the first number becomes 18. 18 and 32. So these are the four conditions. In each of the conditions, we can find A plus B, A plus B, A plus B, A plus B, and maximum was 104. So 104 came out of swapping A1 and B2. So what we did here was we had A1, we had A2, we had B1, we had B2. A1, A2. B1, B2. So if we swap A1 and B2, swap A1 and B2, A1, B2. So basically A1 goes there, so 81, and 2 comes here, which is 23. Now if you sum up this, you get 4. If you sum up this, you get 104, which is our output here. Similarly, you can check the others also. But the main thing is, for because the input here is at most two digit numbers, there are four swaps that are possible. Here, these are the four swaps. You can swap A1, this is swap A1, B1. Swap A2, B2. Swap A1, B2 and swap A2, B1. These are the four swaps possible. In each of these swaps, you can find the sum and find the output. But can we do better? What is basically the sum of 13 plus 82? Of course, it's 95. But how can you write, 13, A1, A2, where A1 is this digit, A2 is the digit 3. We can write A as A1 into 10 plus A2, correct? 1 into 10 plus 3 equal to 13. How can we write B? B is nothing but B into 10 plus B2, B1 into 10 plus B2, 8 into 10 plus B2. Okay, now if we swap A1 and B1, what basically happens? If we swap A1 and B1, B1 came here, this remains A2 here. Now what happens? A1 went there, this remains B2. Because we are swapping the tens digit of both the numbers, the resultant sum will remain the same. How will it be the same? I'll just prove it for this case. This number is B1 A2 now after swapping. Okay, B1 into 10 plus A2. This is our new number. What is our second number? It is A1 into 10 plus b2. Isn't this the same as this? You have a1 into 10 plus a2 if you look at this part, and you have b1 into 10 plus b2. This means that if we swap a1 and b1, if we swap a1 and b1, because we are swapping the tens digit, the tens digit characters or the numbers, the sum remains unaffected, because even now you are going to do 8 into 10, 1 into 10 plus 3 plus 2 to get 95. So it is, you don't even need to consider this case. Similarly, if you swap a2 and b2, because you're swapping the units characters here, now what happens here? Now a1 is here and b1 is here. You swapped a2 and b2. So b2 came here and a2 went there. In this case also it's same. How is it same? a1 into 10 plus b2. This is now our new number 12. Plus b1 into 10 plus a2. This is now our new number b1 a2 here. This is the same as a1 into 10 plus a2 plus b1 into 10 plus b2, which is the same as a plus b here. So this condition also you don't need to check. We only need to check the conditions where we need to swap a1 and b2 and a2 and b1. These are the two conditions we need to check. When we swap a1 and b2, what happens? When basically if we swap a1 and b2, basically these are what we're swapping. So a2 and b1 remain static here. We are swapping a1 and b2. If we swap a1 and b2, so b2 comes here and a1 goes here. So this reduces to, what does it reduce to? B2 into 10 plus a2, b2 into 10 plus a2 plus b1 into 10 plus a1, b1 into 10 plus a1. This is what it reduces to. Now if we swap a2 and b1, if we swap a2 and b1, what happens? If we swap a2 and b1, a1, b2 remain constant, and we are swapping a2 and b1. B1 comes here, a2 goes there. So now what will be this? This will be nothing but a1 into 10 plus b1, a1 into 10 plus b1. What is this? This is nothing but plus a2 into 10 plus b2, a2 into 10 plus b2. So this is what our new sums look like. This is what our new sum 1 looks like. This is what our option 2 sum looks like. Now what? Now we need to note that we cannot do this for, now if a and b are both greater than 10 or greater than equal to, like, you know, they're greater, no problem, they are proper two digit numbers, there are no problem by doing this stuff here. But if a and b, for example, are lesser than 10 or are single digit numbers, or one of those is single digit number, what happens? That is why I've written this condition. If a1, what is a1? A1 is the digit in the tens place. In the second option here, what I characterize as the second option, we are going to swap A1 and B2, which basically means that we need to have like proper A1 and B2 here. What is if A1 mean? If A1 means that the tens digit of, number A, it should exist. For example, let me give you an example of A and B. Okay, if A is 9 and B is 28, we are planning to swap A1 and B2. If we normally code, there are no, A1 does not exist here, only A2 exists here. B1 and B2 both exist, no problem. But since A1 does not exist here, the condition where we swap A1 and B2 does not even arise in this particular test case. So that's why we check if A1, because in C, any non-zero expression is basically evaluated to true. So this checks if the value of a1 is 0. In this particular case, if you compute the tens digit of 9, it is 0 basically. If this is 0, we do not even consider the second option. Why? Because you cannot swap the tens digit of a non-existing. If for 9, what is the tens digit? You don't have a tens digit, because 9, you only have the units digit. You cannot swap this 0 with something else on the right side. So that's why you just check if A1 here. Now, in a similar case, we have if B1 here. If you want to swap A2 and B1, we want to guarantee that B1 exists. Okay, in this particular case, B1 exists. Yes, you can swap. But if B1 does not exist at all, for example, take the case where both are single digit numbers. This is A, this is B. You don't have A1 of A and you don't have B1 of B. So if A1, these two are not even, like, you know, satisfied, because A1 is 0 in this case, B1 also becomes 0 in this case. So our output will be simply A plus B. So what we will do is, we have three things to check. A plus B is one option. The second option is this particular b2 into 10 plus b1 into 10 plus a1 plus a2. The third option is a1 into 10 plus a2 into 10 plus b1 plus b2. These two options, they get evaluated only on a1 when a1 exists and when b1 exists, where a1 and b1 denote the tens digit of the numbers a and b respectively. Because since you do not have a tens digit here, you cannot swap a non-existing zero with these integers here. Hope this part is clear. Now let's look at a common mistake. Now the most common mistake that people do here is they don't read the constraints, because the constraint is written that don't read the constraints, because the constraint is given very clearly that a and b can be at most two digit numbers. The second mistake that people do is they don't handle all the conditions. For example, if you don't handle the condition of this, where both of them do not have a tens digit here and just code it, you will get a wrong output here. Here, you know that for 9 and 9, the output should be 18. Similarly, I suggest you to pause the video for this case and check if your written code satisfies this case. For 10 and 9, the output should be 91. Why 91? Where you swap basically this here. 9 you can swap with 0, I mean you can swap 9 with 0, you can swap 9 with 1 also. But then the output for 10 and 9 should be 91. Because you can swap this 9 in two places. You can swap this 9 next to 0, or you can swap this 9 here also. So for example, if I swap 9 with 1, what happens? 9 comes here, 0 comes here, 1 comes here. 90 plus 1 is 91. So the correct condition is, normally there are 3 options for every test case like I told you. The first case is normal A plus B without swapping is 90. Then I swap A1 and B2. This is A1, this is A2, and this is just, you know, B2. We don't have B1 here. I want to swap A1 and B2. Basically, A1 and B2, if I want to swap, what happens? What I just showed you. If I swap A1 and B2, 9 comes here, 1 goes there. The output is 91. So in this case, 91 was a maximum. The other option was if I swap A2 and B1. Is this valid in this case? B1 does not even exist. So no. So the maximum of these two is 91, and hence 91 is the answer. So write down a few test cases and check if this works for all the test cases. Now let's look at the code of the approach that we have just discussed. Here you look at the Python code. First, we are inputting a and b, and then mapping those two integers to, mapping those two what we get in our input, which is delimited by space, which is a default delimiter for the split function, and assigning those variables to int data type. Then what we do is we perform integer operations. For example, in order to get the a2, a2 is basically the last digit, or the second digit of second digit. By second digit, I mean the last digit or the units digit. Basically, let me just write that so that it's perfectly clear. This is the units digit. This is the tens digit. So to get the units digit is nothing but modulus 10. Then to get the tens digit is nothing but dividing integer division by 10. So I'm using the integer division here, hence the double slash. Then we do b1 and b2 similarly, where b2 is basically the units digit and b1 is basically the tens digit. We then assign maximum is a plus b. Then our first, now I wanted to pause the video and tell me why this code will not work for all test cases. I wanted to pause the video and tell me. And I want you to also tell me in the comments below one particular test case where this code does not work. Please pause the video and try for a second. Now, this code will not work because we are missing two important conditions. Basically, what conditions are we missing here? We are missing the condition of a1 not equal to 0 and b1 not equal to 0. Because if you want to swap a1 b2 or a2 b1, it is very necessary to have these two conditions as discussed. Because if you do not have the tens digit, which will only happen if you have a single digit number, given the constraints of this problem. If you have a single digit number that does not have a tens digit, you cannot swap that with something else. So this check is very, very important. If a1 not equal to 0, we have the same thing what we discussed in the code. b1 into 10 plus b2 into 10 plus a1 plus a2. And then the other thing is if b1 not equal to 0, we consider a1 into 10 plus a2 into 10 plus b1 plus b2 as our other option. So we have three options. First option is the simple sum, a plus b, no swap. Then the second option is this, a1 b2 swap. Third option is A2 B1 swap. Hope this part is clear. Then we find the maximum and print the maximum. So hope this code was clear. Hey guys, that was it. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you haven't yet done this, this is a gentle reminder to hit that subscribe button. If you're interested in competitive programming and data structures, this channel is a one-stop solution for you. See you in the next video. Bye.